Some of the most destructive hurricanes that make landfall in the U.S. start as a group of thunderstorms moving west off the west coast of Africa. This group of storms feeds off the warmth and moisture of the ocean. Air rises then to form more storms and is replaced constantly by the surrounding air. Below all this air rising, low pressure develops. Riding along the trade winds and rotating counterclockwise, thanks to the Coriolis effect, a result of the Earth's rotation, the storm will keep growing as long as it has these key ingredients: water temperatures at or above 79 degrees, ocean water versus land. Hurricanes don't like land. They need open water to survive. And high pressure above it. Weak flow, or what we call a lack of vertical wind shear, above a hurricane is vital to keep it intensifying. Now let's talk about the eye of the hurricane. Always impressive from space, it forms as air rotates up and out of this hurricane. Now, some of the air that's being spit out at the top of the storm then sinks back into the center, keeping the eye itself relatively calm and clear. Immediately surrounding this tranquil eye is the most violent part of the hurricane, the eye wall. The most intense wind speeds at the surface are found right here in the eye wall, but they can extend, of course, out from the storm center. The most destruction in a hurricane comes from the eye wall out to the right quadrant. So you take the already impressive wind speeds inside the hurricane, add the forward motion and the storm surge, and you have a recipe for disaster.